السلام عليكم أهلا وسهلا ومرحبا بكم. In today's lesson we are going to learn الضمائر, the pronouns إن شاء الله. The pronoun in Arabic means ضمير, is a word used in place of a noun. Its plural is الضمائر, the pronouns. There are two types of pronouns in Arabic. First one, الضمائر الشخصية أو المنفصلة. And the second one, الضمائر الملكية أو المتصلة, possessive or attached pronouns. I will only explain the first one in this lesson, inshallah. الضمائر الشخصية أو المنفصلة, personal or detached pronouns. These pronouns can be called as الضمائر الشخصية, personal pronouns, because they denote people in place of nouns. Or they can be called as الضمائر المنفصلة, detached or unattached pronouns, because they are not attached or joined to any word but appear as separate words. They function as المبتدا, subject, in the sentence. There are 14 pronouns. Now here we have two ways to categorize the pronouns. The first one as persons, الغائب. Third person, al-mukhatab or al-hadir, second person, and al-mutakallim, first person. The other way to categorize the pronouns is as numbers, mufrad, singular, muthanna, dual, and jam' plural. Now let's begin. Huwa, he, huma, they two, whom, they all, and these are all مذكر or masculine. هي, she, هما, they two, هن, they all, and these are مؤنث, feminine. These two rows are third person. Now second person, أنت, you, أنتما, you two, أنتم, you all, and these are مذكر, masculine. Anti, you, antuma, you two, antunna, you all, and these are muannath, feminine. And the last one, al-mutakallim, first person, ana, I, and nahnu, we. These two can be used for both male and female. As we see, there is no special form of dual for nahnu. It can be used for both dual and plural. They are مذكر and مؤنث, masculine and feminine. There's no female form. They can be used for male and female. These pronouns must be memorized. If you think that this way will be difficult to memorize, we have another way to list the pronouns in the same order. Now here we have the pronouns in the same order. Huwa, huma, hum. Hiya, huma, hunna. Anta, antuma, antum. Anti, antuma, antunna. Ana, nahnu. Let's go back. See, the order is same. Huwa, huma, hum. Hiya, huma, hunna. Anta, antuma, antum. Anti, antuma, antunna. Ana, nahnu. These six rows are third person, and the next six rows are second person, and the last two rows are first person. They don't actually mean third person, second person, first person. We call them in English so, but in Arabic it means al-ghaib, absent, the one who is not present with you. Al-mukhatab, al-hadir, the present, the one who is present with you. Al-mutakallim is speaker, the one who is speaking. Now let's use them in a sentence. Huwa, he, huwa talibun, he is a student. Huma, they two, huma talibani, they two are students. Hum, they all, hum tullabun, they all are students. These three are mudhakkar, masculine. Hiya, she, hiya talibatun, she is a student. Huma, ليتهما طالبتان. They two are students. هن, they all. هن طالبات. They all are students. And these three are مؤنث, feminine. As we see, there are two هما, they two, and هما, they two. It's same, exactly same, but in a sentence when we use with a noun, the noun must be masculine and feminine. هما طالبان for masculine, and هما طالبتان for feminine. Let's go to the next. المخاطب or الحاضر, second person. أنت يو, أنت طالب, you are a student. أنتما, you two, أنتما طالبان, you two are students. أنتم, you all, أنتم طلاب, you all are students. These three rows are مذكر, masculine. أنت يو, أنت طالبة, you are a student. أنتما, you two, أنتما طالبتان, you two are students. أنتن, you all, أنتن طالبات, you all are students. And these three rows are مؤنث, feminine. And last, two rows are المتكلم, first person. أنا, I, أنا طالب or طالبة, I am a student. Remember we said and can be used for male and female. نحن, we, نحن طالبان or طالبتان, or طلاب or طالبات, we two or we all are students. Remember we said نحن also can be used for male and female, and there's no special dual form of نحنو, it can be used for dual and plural. So we use for masculine dual and feminine dual, and we use masculine plural and feminine plural. Before I conclude the lesson, I would like to mention a very important point with regards to the pronouns. Let's imagine we have a male student in the class and the rest of the students are female. Doesn't matter how many students are there, but the rest is female and we have one male student. And you want to say in Arabic, they are students. In English, there is only one word means they for male and female. In Arabic, there are two words mean they, one for male and one for female. So which one must be used for this class? Male or female? هم طلابون, they all are male students. And the next option is هن طالباتون, they all are female students. In the first one we use masculine pronoun and masculine plural, and in the next one we use feminine pronoun and feminine plural. According to the rule, is the first one correct and the next one is wrong. So, in the class, if there is one student and the remaining of the students are female, but we must still use the masculine form of pronoun. Previously, we learned that there are two types of Arabic pronouns. First, الضمائر الشخصية أو المنفصلة, personal or detached pronouns. And the second, الضمائر الملكية أو المتصلة, possessive or attached pronouns. In our previous lesson, we learned the first one in detail. Now we are going to learn the second one. الضمائر الملكية أو المتصلة, possessive or attached pronouns. These pronouns can be called as الضمائر الملكية, possessive pronouns, because they indicate possession. Or they can be called as الضمائر المتصلة, attached pronouns, because they are attached or joined to a noun, verb or particle. They indicate possession if they are joined to a noun, and they indicate direct object if they are joined to a verb. They are also 14 in number. Remember we said that in our previous lesson, there are two ways to categorize Arabic pronouns. The first way is as persons, such as third person, second person, and first person. And the other way to categorize the pronouns is as numbers: singular mufrad and dual muthanna or plural jam'. Now let's begin. Who, huma, hum. These are mudhakkar, masculine. Ha, huma, hunna. And these are muannath, feminine. Ka, kuma, kum. And these are mudhakkar, masculine. Ki, kuma, kunna. And these are muannath, feminine. Ya and na. These are mudhakkar or muannath, masculine or feminine. They can be used for both masculine or feminine. The pronouns can be listed like this or like this. And in this table, I listed both detached and attached pronouns together. So it will be easier for us to learn them according to the same order. The first six rows are third person, and the next six rows are second person, and the last two rows are first person. Let's remember the personal pronouns: huwa, huma, hum, hiya, huma, hunna, anta, antuma, antum, anti, antuma, antunna, ana, nahnu. And attached pronouns: who, huma, hum, ha, huma, hunna, ka, kuma, kum, ki, kuma, kunna, ya, na. Who means his, him, it, or its, and it is singular. Huma, their, or them, dual. Hum, their, or them, plural. Ha means hers, her, it, or its, singular. Huma, their, them, dual. Hunna, their, or them, plural. Ka, or you, singular. Kuma, your, or you, dual. Kum, your, or you, plural. Ki, your, or you, singular. Kuma, your, or you, dual. Kunna, your, or you, plural. Ya, my, or me, singular. Na, ours, or us, dual, or plural. As you see, most of them are translated same in English, but they differ in Arabic. Huma is dual, hum is plural. And here also, ka, kuma, kum, ki, kuma, kunna are all same in English, because in English there is only one you or your, but in Arabic they are all different. Singular, dual, and plural for masculine and feminine, all different. We must learn attached pronouns together with personal pronouns. And in the next table, I will give example with nouns. In this table, we are going to learn how to join attached pronouns to a noun. Hu, kitabuhu, his book. Huma, kitabuhuma, their book. Hum, kitabuhum, their book. Singular, dual, and plural. Mudhakkar, masculine. Ha, kitabuha, her book. Singular. Huma, kitabuhuma, their book, dual. Hunna, kitabuhunna, their book, plural. And these are feminine, muannath. Ka, kitabuka, your book, singular. Kuma, kitabukuma, your book, dual. Kum, kitabukum, your book, plural. These are second person, mudhakkar, masculine. Ki, kitabuki, your book, singular. Kuma, kitabukuma, your book, dual. Kunna, kitabukunna, your book, plural. And these are second person, feminine, muannath. Ya, kitabi, my book, singular. Na, كتابنا our book dual or plural and these are for both masculine and feminine مذكر and مؤنث. And in this table we are going to learn how to join attached pronouns to a verb. The verb I chose is ضرب, means to hit, to strike. It is the root verb ضرب, and then we attach pronouns. Who ضربهُ, he hit him. هما ضربهما, he hit them. Dual. هم ضربهم, he hit them. Plural. These are third person masculine, مذكر. ها ضربها, he hit her. هما ضربهما, he hit them. Dual. هن ضربهن, he hit them. Plural. And these are third person مؤنث, feminine. ك ضربك, he hit you. Singular. كما ضربكما, he hit you. Dual. كم ضربكم, he hit you. Plural. كي ضربكي, he hit you. Singular. كما ضربكما, he hit you. Dual. كنا ضربكنا, he hit you. Plural. يا ضربني, he hit me. نا ضربنا, he hit us. Dual or plural. For this here we need to add nun. In order to make it easier to pronounce the verb, nun must be added. ضربني, only for the first person. And in this table we are going to learn how to join attached pronouns to a particle, preposition. I use the preposition إلى, means to. هو إليه, to him. هما إليهما, to them. Dual. هم إليهم, to them. Plural. ها إليها, to her. هما إليهما, to them. Dual. هن إليهن, to them. Plural. ك إليك, to you. Singular. كما إليكما, to you. Dual. كم إليكم, to you. Plural. كي إليك, to you. Singular. كما إليكما, to you. Dual. كنا إليكنا, to you. Plural. يا إلي, to me. Singular. نا إلينا, to us. Dual or plural. Here we added تشديد. Instead of writing twice, we need to write تشديد. And one more point before we conclude the lesson. As we see, ha, the letter ha gets كسرة. But in original form it is ضمة. As we see, هو, هما, هم, ها, هما, هن. We must know that pronouns are مبني or indeclinable nouns. مبني means the last haraka never changes, whatever they have before them. But in this case, they are not changed to كسرة because of إلى, but rather to make pronunciation easier or better. هو إليه, هما إليهما, هم إليهم, هما إليهما, and هن إليهن.
Demonstrative pronouns. The demonstrative pronoun in Arabic is ismul ishara, is a noun used to demonstrate or point at object or person. The plural is asma'ul ishara, demonstrative pronouns. There are two types of demonstrative pronouns. First, lil qarib, for near objects or people, and the second one, lil ba'id, distant object or people. Now we have singular demonstrative pronouns, dual and plural. And the first is lil qarib, near demonstrative pronouns. Mudhakkar masculine pronouns are هذا this هذاني these two هؤلاء these more than two object or persons. The second مؤنث feminine for near هذه this هاتاني these two هؤلاء these more than two object or person. هؤلاء is same for both feminine and masculine. And the next one is للبعيد distant demonstrative pronouns. First مذكر masculine demonstrative pronouns for distant ذلك that ذلك those two أولئك those more than two. And next is مؤنث feminine distant demonstrative pronouns تلك that تانك those two and أولئك those. Again these two are same for masculine and feminine. Now let's use them in a sentence. First we are going to learn المفرد singular demonstrative pronouns. للقريب near demonstrative pronouns هذا بيت جميل. This is a beautiful house. Another way of saying this sentence is هذا البيت جميل. This house is beautiful. The meaning is same, difference is only the translation. As we see هذا بيت جميل, this is a beautiful house, and here هذا البيت جميل. This house is beautiful. Example for feminine هذه سيارة غالية. This is an expensive car, and we say this in another way هذه السيارة غالية. This car is expensive. This is an expensive car. This car is expensive. And for distant examples ذلك رجل كريم. That is a nobleman. And ذلك الرجل كريم. That man is noble. That is a nobleman. That man is noble. For feminine تلك بنت ذكية. That is a clever girl. And تلك البنت ذكية. That girl is clever. Please note that if demonstrative pronoun occurs as subject or مبتدا, then the predicate خبر will generally be indefinite or نكرة. However, if predicate or خبر is also definite or معرفة, then a personal pronoun must be added between the subject and predicate. Now let's understand better with examples. هذا كتاب. A very simple sentence means this is a book. It will be هذا هو الكتاب. Indefinite noun became definite noun, and we need to add a personal pronoun between the demonstrative pronoun and the noun. هذا هو الكتاب, and that means this is the book. We do not need to translate هو, but rather we say in our translation this is the book. An example for feminine هذه حقيبة. This is a bag. It will be هذه هي الحقيبة. This is the bag. This is a bag. This is the bag. And the next المثنى dual demonstrative pronouns. Examples هذان بيتان جميلان. These two are beautiful houses. And another way of saying this sentence is هذان البيتان جميلان. These two houses are beautiful. These two are beautiful houses. These two houses are beautiful. As we see, if the demonstrative pronoun is dual, then the noun also must be dual, as well as the khabar predicate also must be dual. Example for feminine هاتان شجرتان كبيرتان. These two are big trees. And it will be هاتان الشجرتان كبيرتان. These two trees are big. These two are big trees. These two trees are big. Please note that all demonstrative pronouns are indeclinable except dual forms. In dual forms, the letter alif becomes ya in accusative and genitive case as following. Hadani will be hadaini. Hatani will be hataini. Dhanika will be dhainika. And tanika will be tainika. Let's choose in the sentence. قرأت هذين الكتابين. I read these two books. This is in accusative case. I read these two books. And let's give example for genitive case. سلمت على هاتين البنتين. I greeted these two girls. In both cases, alif becomes ya. هذاني became هذيني and هاتاني became هاتيني. And the next one, الجمع, plural, demonstrative pronouns. Examples, هؤلاء طلاب مجتهدون. These are hardworking students. Now we used plural demonstrative pronoun and the noun also became plural as well as the khabar, predicate also became plural. Example for feminine, هؤلاء بنات مصريات. These are Egyptian girls. These are for near. هؤلاء is for near and أولئك for distant. أولئك طلاب مجتهدون. Those are hardworking students. These are hardworking students. And those are hardworking students. أولئك بنات مصريات. هؤلاء بنات مصريات. أولئك بنات مصريات. Those are Egyptian girls. These are Egyptian girls. And those are Egyptian girls. Please also note that if the noun is inanimate object, غير عاقل, then the demonstrative pronoun and its predicate or adjective must be singular and feminine. How? Let's understand in a sentence. هذه السيارات جميلة. These cars are beautiful. السيارات is plural of السيارة, the car. And it is inanimate object. In this case, we must use singular and feminine demonstrative pronoun. هذه, not هؤلاء or أولئك. And also the خبر or predicate must also be singular and feminine. Another example, تلك البيوت كبيرة. Those houses are big. البيوت is the plural of البيت, the house. Those houses are big. It is inanimate object and the demonstrative pronoun must be singular and feminine as well as the khabar or predicate must also be singular and feminine.
The relative pronoun in Arabic is al-ism al-mawsul, is a word which has a relation or connection to the sentence following it, meaning that which, who or whom. The plural is al-asma' al-mawsulah, the relative pronouns. They are as following. We have singular, dual, and plural relative pronouns. The first is al-mudhakkar, masculine relative pronouns. Al-ladhi, singular. Al-ladhani or al-ladhaini, dual. And al-ladhina, plural. And next, مؤنث, feminine relative pronouns. التي, singular. اللتان or اللتين, dual. And اللاتي or اللائي, plural. اللاتي and اللائي are same. There is no difference, but اللاتي used most. And here there are two dual. The first one is used in nominative case, and the second one is used in accusative and genitive case. Same as here, allatani and allataini. Now let's learn in the sentence. The first one is al-mufrad, singular. رجع الطالب الذي سافر إلى بلده. The student who traveled to his country returned. رجع returned. الطالب the student الذي هو سافر إلى بلده traveled to his country. An example for feminine. هذه هي الطالبة التي تدرس كثيرا. This is the student who studies a lot. The female student. This is the female student التي هو تدرس كثيرا studies a lot. Next example. قرأت الكتاب الذي اشتريته أمس. I read the book which I bought yesterday. قرأت I read الكتاب the book الذي which or that اشتريته I bought أمس yesterday. This is masculine and the next is feminine. وجدت الحقيبة التي فقدتها في مطار جدة. I found the bag that I lost in Jeddah airport. وجدت I found الحقيبة the bag التي that or which فقدتها I lost it في مطار جدة in Jeddah airport. And the next one is المثنى dual relative pronouns. Example الرجلان اللذان من باكستان صالحان. The two men who are from Pakistan are pious. Ar-rajulani, the two men, alladhani, who are min Pakistan, from Pakistan, salihani, are righteous. An example for feminine, at-talibatani, allatani, min misra, mujtahidatani. The two students, the two female students who are from Egypt are hardworking. At-talibatani, the two female students, allatani, who are min Misra, from Egypt, mujtahidatani, are hardworking. Please note that the letter alif becomes ya in accusative and genitive case as following. Alladhani becomes Alladhaini and Allatani becomes Allataini. Now let's use in the sentence. Zurtu Ar-Rajulaini Alladhaini Ra'aytuhuma fi Suq. I visited the two men whom I saw in marketplace. Zurtu I visited Ar-Rajulaini the two men Alladhaini whom رأيتهما I saw في السوق in the shop in marketplace. As we see, this noun الرجلين is dual and it is in accusative case, and relative pronoun must also be in accusative case. An example for feminine, قرأت القصتين اللتين سمعتهما من أستاذي. I read the two stories that I heard from my teacher. قرأت I read القصتين the two stories اللتين that or which سمعتهما I heard من أستاذي from my teacher. And the next one is الجمع plural relative pronouns. Examples الأشخاص الذين يجلسون هناك أصدقائي. The people who are sitting there are my friends. الأشخاص is the plural of شخص, person, people. The people الذين who are يجلسون sitting هناك there أصدقائي are my friends. Example for feminine, البناتُ اللاتي or اللائي. اللاتي or اللائي حضرن الآن من الكويت. The girls who came now are from Kuwait. البنات, the girls, اللاتي or اللائي, who حضرنا, came, they came, الآن, now, من الكويت, are from Kuwait. Please note that if the noun is inanimate plural object, the relative pronoun will be singular and feminine. Examples: الكتب التي قرأتها مفيدة جدا. The books which I read are very useful. الكتب is the plural of كتاب and it is inanimate object and plural. And the relative pronoun, that's why it must be singular and feminine if the noun is inanimate plural object. The relative pronoun must be singular and feminine. The books which I read are very useful. انظر إلى هذه السيارات التي أمام الشركة. Look at these cars that are in front of the company. انظر, look, إلى هذه السيارات. Look at these cars. التي, which or that, أمام الشركة, in front of the company. Both of them must be followed by singular and feminine relative pronouns. Besides these relative pronouns that mention in the table, there are two more relative pronouns which are not mentioned in the table, and they are ما and من. ما and من are also used as relative pronouns. ما means what, used only for objects and things. من means who or whom, used for humans only. Examples: الله يعلم ما تفعلون. Allah knows what you do. يعلم knows ما what تفعلون you do. Allah knows what you do. It's also a related pronoun. الله يعلم من يعبده. Allah knows who worships him. من هو يعبده, worships him. Allah knows who worships him. That's all for today's lesson. See you next lesson, inshallah. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.